is something new, and it's also immune to red. So if you know a lot of things are using the red. And what is not? It's not a relational database. It's not a replacement for relational databases. It also is not an object-oriented database. So it doesn't have an object-oriented layer for programming or another programming language. Yeah, I want to talk about the CAP term.
That's how you make that box.
CAP term, basically, you have in your data applications, you have the consistency, availability, and your partition tolerance. So what this tells you is you can't have all of the three. You can't be partition tolerant, saying that you have consistent availability. So it's just you need to pick two out of three. So in the base of CouchDB, you take the first two, the availability and partition tolerance, and the next slide you're going to see. So it's not consistent. Facebook is using a similar technique. They have their own Amazon S3. In the back end, if you look at it, sometimes you see your status is being not updated because that partition didn't get your updates. Or, you know, you see your friend count maybe altering, and this is just being stuff is a consistency. It's just going to eventually things are going to go and be stable, but you're not going to get that. As far as the CAP term, so in the case of the CAP term in the Venn diagram, you see where CouchDB sits in here in between the partition tolerance and the availability. And the typical relational database sits in this area between the consistency. So it's not very tolerant to a partition. It uses a B-tree storage engine. And this is something new. So instead of using the database, so you have this storage engine they call views. So your query goes into different, it goes through the tree and then gets to the data, and then you store the data in your view state through some JSON type format. And it's always, it also embraces the HTTP web verbs, so get to input post, in both those forms. So, just wanted to say, so in the case of a web, so you have your different nodes in your cluster, right? Your storage, your database. This could be in a different zone. Let's say this is Amazon S3. So let's say these two nodes are down. And this connection is down. These two guys are down. So what happens is when the connection is down, when they come up, these guys are already changed the state. So records, maybe you're doing some analysis here. This is not a good place for, you know, obviously you got to design for failure. The idea is when these guys come out, they're going to come back and get their updates from the working node, so they're going to eventually run into a merge into a consistent state. So you don't have that. So you have to plan for design for failure is big in this kind of application. So I want to do a little demo. You can get the CouchDB through CouchDB, couchbase.org. I don't have it here, but let me see here. And it does run on Windows, although I haven't installed it yet, but it's open source, obviously. So here you can run, it's a web-based application, so once you get it down there, your application finder, CouchDB server. This is going to open up a port. I can just say, this is going to say the welcome screen. So that's available with CouchDB. That just tells you that it's already up and running. You need the curl statement to get your data. You can also get a full get statement to get your own existing databases. So I just have quick post database in this environment, and there is another interface called Futon. I know you guys are very excited about to see that, about learning about this. So there's a Futon app. Futon is the web interface. You can see here you can create a new database and run it again. So it runs in a browser. You don't have to download 3 gigabytes of loads of SQL Server. It's just built into it. It's available and supported multiple platforms, Mac, Linux, Windows. So check it out and As far as recommendations go? Recommendations.
So yeah, it's a new way of viewing data. You're gonna have the CouchDB, the book is free, you can go to the website, get the book, use the HTTP local beta. And it's all about relaxing, so don't forget to relax and enjoy the CouchDB. Thank you.